If you are a giver by nature, you love to help other people, you treat people the way you want them to treat you, right? But there have been times when you have felt taken advantage of, especially in the dating world. Women are conditioned to give. We are told, give, 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 and we feel good when we're giving. But when we don't put limits on our giving, we turn into a doormat and we get no respect. And this is especially important during the courtship phase of dating. It's important to see how much a man is willing to invest in you on all levels, time, finances, and physical effort. So that means that he's willing to spend time with you. He is willing to drive a little bit of a distance to get together with you. You're not always the one making all the effort. He offers to pay. There is actually science that says that the giver, a giver, feels closer and more committed to a recipient of their giving. That's why we enjoy giving so much. So when you allow a man to give to you, he actually feels good, he feels connected to you, and he feels more committed to you. He is going to want to give you more. And women have a hard time receiving what a man wants to give. So this is science, ladies. This is based on science. And what you're doing is you're actually building a safety net so that when it's time for you to give, you feel more sure of his intentions and you're not left second guessing and wondering why you're giving, giving, giving and feeling depleted. Let's talk about how you can apply this to your dating life, especially during the courtship phase. And I'm going to talk at the end about what happens when the courtship's over and you're in relationship in terms of give and take. So step number one is say yes to his gifts and his favors. Tell him, I really enjoy when a man drives to my area. That really means a lot to me. Thank you so much for taking me to a nice restaurant. Step number two is always express gratitude. Thank you, thank you, thank you when you're on the date. Now, I don't believe you have to do a thank you email and a thank you, you know, text, because then you're stuck in this cycle of giving, giving, giving again. You have already thanked him. You have let him know, I really enjoyed meeting you. I really appreciate that you came all this way to meet me. Thank you so much for a delicious meal, a fantastic conversation, and I really appreciate it, and I would love to see you again sometime. That's all on the date. No guessing whether you had a good time or not. No guessing whether you have gratitude. You're not entitled, but you are showing him, I appreciate that you give, and you're making it safe for him to keep on giving and make him feel good, because men are providers. The next thing is you want to ask for favors in return. Ask for help. And what we tend to do is not ask for help enough. And men offer our help and we refuse their help. So that's another way of us not always giving, but of receiving. A man offers to carry your bag. Oh, thank you so much. Even if you got it, ladies, we're all strong, healthy humans. Most of us are doing really well. And we don't need a man to carry a bag for us. But again, we want a man to be able to bond to us and feel good about giving. We have to be able to ask for it. We usually start giving from the beginning of the dating process and we don't even get to the relationship. Or we give during the relationship and we're completely depleted. So if you do this the right way with him investing in you and showing his commitment to you, that builds that safety net for you to start giving back. And even during that courtship phase, you might want to pick up the tip. You might want to, you know, do small favors in return. That shows goodwill. That shows that you're not entitled. And that will go a long way to a man wanting to give you even more. The time for you to give a lot, to start having like 5-course meals over at your place, is when you already have his commitment. I'm a firm believer of this. And when you start to do things this way, you are going to have men who value you more, who respect you more, who cherish you more, who want to give to you, who want to take care of you, even though you can take care of yourself. So that is how you give without being depleted, without feeling taken advantage of, and you actually get valued more.